Hey guys, it's Julio with Curb Appeal Pros. First, make sure to like, share, and subscribe to our channel so we can continue to make great content. Well, you're probably wondering what we're doing here. We're building another flatbed. Yep, we're super excited about it. We love building rigs. Whether it's a box truck, a flatbed, an enclosed trailer, an open trailer, we've done it all. Right now in our current fleet, we're adding our third vehicle as we've built them before and sold them. But right now we're just currently building this one because we're looking for something with a smaller footprint. Back here you can see our 16-foot flatbed with our F450 Super Duty turbo diesel. This thing is a beast. It takes us anywhere we want to go. It has everything we want and need on it, and also some things we don't need on it just in case, because you can never be too prepared out in the field. But what we wanted with this build was a smaller footprint than what we have behind us, and also our 16-foot enclosed trailer. Because as you already know, a 16-foot enclosed trailer with a truck attached to it is super long. So we wanted this build to be able to get into smaller spaces, whether it's a parking garage, a customer's house that has a small driveway, a rural area. Basically, we wanted it to be the best of both worlds and get us anywhere we needed it to. So we get asked questions a lot in regards to how we build our rigs, what we use, what equipment, how we protect the flatbed itself, and the roofing. Basically everything about a rig we get asked. So we're gonna go ahead and have a little series here. This is gonna be considered chapter one. We're gonna document everything that we do from beginning to end. So that way, if you ever have any questions or doubts in your mind, you can just come back to one of these videos and look at what we've done and maybe apply it to yours. Or if you have any questions, you can always comment below or give us a call, send a pigeon with a message. Whatever you wanna do, just let us know. So, you know, we're here to help. That's why we're doing this entire series for you. So here, we're gonna go ahead and dive right into it. You're gonna see here is kind of a little bit bare bones, but the reason for that is because this is chapter one. We're going to show you our flatbed itself. We're going to show you what stuff we use to go ahead and protect it, and then the added layer of protection that we added to it, because flatbeds are amazing. They're very open, they look great, they're spacious, you can get to everything very easily, but also the downside to that is that they are open. So they're open to the elements. So you always wanna make sure that you protect that investment. The flatbed's huge, the equipment that's on there is huge, so you always wanna make sure that that's always protected from the sun, rain, basically everything that's outdoor, you wanna make sure it's protected from. So it's almost like having an enclosed trailer or a box truck, but with a flatbed build to it. So I'm gonna go ahead and dive right into it and show you what we're gonna be doing and what we're using in order for us to protect this flatbed and go ahead and start moving on. Again, chapter one in this series of flatbed build. Thanks. Here is our flatbed build, guys. This is our 2012 F250 V8 crew cab. The reason we went with a V8 this time is because it's a little bit more fuel efficient. It's definitely powerful, and we don't need it to haul as much as we did with the 16-foot flatbed, so we don't need the turbo diesel in this truck, so it's perfect for us. I'm gonna go ahead and document from top to bottom for you guys so you can see exactly what we're doing with this build. As you can see here, here's our rack. It's a lot smaller than the other rack here, but the reason we did that is we wanted to mimic it so we can go ahead and do the same advertising. This advertising has brought in countless amount of money in regards to the business itself. We love it, it pops, people really notice it, it conveys the message that we're needing it to, and it also showcases the rig itself. People always give us compliments in regards to the rig, how they've never seen anything so nice and so big. So that's something that we wanted to convey with this smaller footprint of a rig, and that's up here. Next, what I'm gonna go ahead and show you here is the G-floor. This is the coin style G-floor. It is a rubber or PVC floor, and it actually holds up to the elements really, really well. The reason we put this on here is because it's chemical resistant, it's slip proof, it's very, very protective. While that is protective as well, we went ahead and coated the flatbed with an epoxy polyurethane coat. It's very, very durable. It's actually chemical resistant. We got it specifically so it would be resistant to sodium hypochlorite, and that's exactly what it does. Our other flatbed has now gone a year with it on there, and it's looking great. So we decided to go ahead and mimic that on here as well. If you guys need any information about that, give us a call or shoot us a message, and we can get you in contact with the person or the people that will be able to get you that specific product for your two-step protection of the flatbed. We really love using this G-floor. We've used this in every single build of the rig that we've done because it's so durable. You can just wipe things off. It's very clean. If you have any oil spills or anything on it, you can just wipe it right up and it looks great. It's very, very durable. As you can see here, we buy it in 17-foot rolls. So we have a lot left over on this build so we can kind of showcase exactly how
thick it is. So as you can see here, it's super thick, but not thick enough to where you're not able to work with it. It's a great design. It's, you know, like I said before, it's slip resistant and it works very, very well, and it's very economical for protection. You'll find a link below in regards to being able to purchase this directly, so it can get sent to you, so that way you can go ahead and use it yourself if you want to. We personally recommend it because it works very, very well time and time again. That's why we use it in every single build. As you can see here, we have a luggage rack that we added on here. We're going to be adding our surface cleaners on here because we have a Whisper Wash Classic and also a big guy that we're going to go ahead and mount on this, so that way it takes up less space on the flatbed itself. Under the actual flatbed itself, we had some coating done, so that way it protects anything just in case anything gets through, which nothing ever does, but you never ever want to be too careful, because you want to make sure that you protect your investment of the truck itself. So that's basically what we use here. We've went ahead and lined everything down on the mat with these transition pieces that you can go ahead and get at Lowe's or Home Depot. And the reason for this is we put a huge, huge bead of silicone in there, so it makes it water resistant on here and in here. So that way no water can get trapped in here, but it also helps pull the mat down, and it kind of helps enclose or encase anything that gets spilled on the mat itself. As you can see here, it's a little raised, and that's exactly the point. We kind of wanted a bathtub effect, but nothing without having too high a side so that would get in the way, because we're going to be mounting our gravity fed tanks here that are stackable. We're also going to have our pressure washer, our reels back here. We're basically going to have the whole shebang on here, so we wanted to make sure it's as efficient and as protected as possible. So if you guys have any questions in regards to the products that we've used, how we do it, what we're doing, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel, and give us a comment, or go ahead and let us know anything that you need, or if you have any suggestions, or if you have anything basically that you want to ask. Thanks a lot for watching, and again, make sure to like, share, and subscribe, and we'll continue to bring this series to you. Thanks.